So January 1st is approaching so fast, and of course that's gonna kick off the new 2024 year. Oh, hello, Stella. She just butts in my videos. Anyway, sorry to get sidetracked there. January 1st has probably the biggest Lego release, and we are seeing, I don't know, over like, I think it was like 150 Lego sets that are going to be releasing of January 1st of 2024. So I thought in today's video, we would take a deep dive through every single set that is coming soon. And of course, focusing on the January 1st releases because we'll be doing a January 1st midnight live stream. We need to order a Lego plushie anyways. I'm not sure exactly what we're going to order for the new year just yet. I normally grab the modular, but obviously that changed because the modular came out in December of 2023. I'm not sure if it's a 2024 set, but so many different dilemmas. But anyways, if that interests you, stick around, hit that subscribe button for our dear friend Stella, who will be joining us in today's video. Well, she'll be hanging out here in my office. But let's jump straight on into it, guys. Now that you subscribe, appreciate you guys. We're making our journey to 30,000, which is pretty epic. So love you guys, and let's continue on with our video. So the first set is going to be the, I don't know how to pronounce this, guys. You guys butcher me on my English anyways. The Blank Collection Macaw Parrots. A really, really cool set. I think this is very interesting. I remember, so Lego had emailed me. They emailed me a bunch of sets to kind of release for January 1st to review. And this one got thrown on that list, and I actually declined the review. And I kind of regret it looking at it. It's like super unique, super cool. I was very overwhelmed with how many sets they were sending. And I just, you don't have to review everything, right? So, but anyways, still a really cool set. $60 for this bad boy. I think it's a little bit high on the price point, 644 pieces. But it is a part of the Lego Icons line, and Lego Art, I guess, is kind of the deal there. Anyways, that one's going to be releasing January 1st. We do have one Brickheadz that's going to be coming to the collection here, and that is going to be the Spring Festive Mickey Mouse. Now, I started on that rabbit hole of collecting the Lego Brickheadz, but it got steered away as there was like, I don't know, maybe 100 made in like 2022 and 100 made in 2023. But this is one I think I want to get. Pretty cool Brickheadz, I would say. I do like it, and it's, Disney, it's Mickey, and it's pretty cool. So I'll probably pick that one up, maybe not day one, but eventually. Next up, we have a Lego City launch, so I could briefly hit some of these sets. we have the Police Prison Island. Guys, this set looks cool. I love the box art on it as well. It features a nice, what you would probably find on a prison island, right? You got some boat rafts too, a chase going on, a helicopter in there, a shark. Really cool looking set. I'm actually really impressed with this one. Finally, I feel like it's definitely a good step in the Lego City direction. I feel like we've had a few rough patches of years, but wow, holy minifigs. That is cool. That is a cool set. Anyways, $100 for that one. Nice little decent little set. We have a modular space station, and that's pretty unique. Has like modular little more like residency camp things here. Of course, this year, Lego specializing in the space. I forget how many years, 20, 30, 25, 40, I'm not sure. But it has all the space logos on different themes of sets, so that's a pretty cool one to add to it. Next, we have a sailboat. Just a sailboat for $20. That's pretty decent price point for a decent little set. 100 pieces, though. Two minifigs, $20. Maybe a little bit steep on the price, but you do get that plastic sail, it looks like, and a dolphin included in that one. Next up, we have the Command Rover and Crane Loader. I imagine, yeah, I would say I'd imagine that's a space themed one as well. This looks pretty interesting. I love the eight-wheeler on this. The minifigs look, I'm gonna actually open this one up. This one actually looks pretty cool as well. I love looking at Lego, guys. This little like droid-looking dude looks epic. But $85 seems like an odd price point. Maybe it could be reduced a little bit considering 758 pieces. I'm sure we'll see this one go on rollback quite soon just because it's, a Lego City set, not really more on licensing. So yeah, it feels to me more of like, maybe it's 70, maybe $60 set. We also have the Interstellar Spaceship. This is again being a Lego City on top of the space. Looks like a nice little spaceship as well. 240 pieces, one minifig included in this one. Cool little set there. A really cool set is the burger truck from the Lego City line at $20. I saw this and I was like, dang, I have to get this. It's cool. Features like all black, like almost like a, I don't know, a box truck. And then on the back, it's not a box, it's a burger. So that was really cool. I like the price point on it. Pretty attractive set to me. We also have the Police Mobile Crime Lab truck. Very interesting design. I actually love this one as well. I think these little LEGO City sets are very strong this year. it's a crime lab. I mean, it's cool. What else to say there? We have a fire station with fire truck. It's more of like a modern fire station. Was a cool one. $80. Again, maybe a little bit high on the price point, but a really cool set nonetheless. We also have a space base rocket launch pad. Again, getting that space logo on the box. $135 seems a little bit steep, but you do get a lot in this one, being just an entire launch station with a rocket ship. We do have a few smaller sets like the construction steamroller, nice little city throw in. Not surprised to see this one in at the $10 price point for 78 pieces. We have a fire rescue plane. Always good to see another LEGO plane come out, especially in the LEGO City line. And again, this one dialected to the fire truck. We also have a police car and muscle car chase. Pretty self-explanatory. Police car, muscle car, two minifigs. Nice little chase going on. $20. Great way to get two little cars. We have a spaceship and an asteroid discovery. Again, more lines of another spaceship. Kind of reminds me of the one we talked about just a little bit ago. Too many figs in that one. Little small builds on the side as well. We have an emergency rescue helicopter in the emergency colors, the like teal greenish color. Too many things in that one for $20. We also have the Space Explorer Rover and Alien Life. This is a six-wheeler. Looks pretty modern, I would say. It looks really good. $35. Gets the space logo on it. Another cool looking set. We have a Space Construction Mech. Not sure why this one's not $10 and it's $11, but maybe it's because they got that space logo and people collecting the space theme are going to have to get it. So LEGO's going to get that extra dollar out of you. But I love my mechs. Cool to see a space one. I don't think we've seen a lot of LEGO City mechs before, but interesting one, right? Fire rescue helicopter, $10. I feel like we've seen a lot of sets like this in the years past. No surprises there. We have an emergency ambulance set, similar to kind of like that promo one, except this is a 4+. We have a fire rescue motorcycle, again, being in the $10 range. We have go-karts and race car drivers. I'll probably pick this up at some point. I love these little go-karts. They're so cool. I've always wanted to build the LEGO go-kart track in my LEGO City, so maybe that'll inspire me to do so. We have a green race car. I believe this looks very similar to the one that is already out there. It's in not a 4+ set, but oh, man, it looks very similar. Anyways, we have another fire rescue set. It's the fire truck with rescue boat, a little boat rescue and a fire truck. That's pretty cool. Police speedboat and Crook's hideout. Two like speedboats there. One's a jet ski and a rodder on a jet ski, and looks like to me what to be a container. And next, we have a race car and car carrier truck. This is a really, really cool set. I definitely will be picking this up at some point. $30 seems a little bit steep, but it's a set I definitely want to add into my LEGO City / collection. You get a race car and a truck. It's cool. I like it a lot. And the last LEGO City set is the blue monster truck for $16. Always nice to see a little monster truck come out. But anyways, that's going to cover the LEGO City line. Now, let's jump into some of the LEGO creator sets. Just briefly, just because they're not too exciting, it's just more creator boxes. We have a creative vehicles back for $55. We have a creative house pack, which is pretty cool and unique. You get a lot of good pieces for building mocks and whatnot. That one's also $55. We have a creative pets pack, which is $35. And then lastly, we have a creative space plants, which will get, of course, our new space logo. So that one is $35 as well. Jumping into LEGO Creator 3-in-1. I believe, actually, I think this is just LEGO Creator. Yeah, no, Creator 3-in-1. Not sure why the Moscow parrots are in there. Maybe you could build those separate ways. But anyways, we'll get to review a few of these, but there's a bunch of really cool LEGO sets on here. The retro camera is on here. That is pretty sweet. I love it. It's a really cool looking set for $20. I'm not sure. I can't really tell what the other builds are, but I would definitely go the camera route. It looks incredible. It's a very just well-designed. I think one of those is a little TV maybe, and then a tape recorder. Okay, that's pretty cool. Anyways, solid little sets there. We have a flowers in the water can for $30. We have the tropical ukulele, which we did a few full review on our channel. That one's $30. I think a little bit high on the price point. We have an exotic parrot that looks really good for $20. We have a giraffe. Again, looks really awesome. This one is $65. Definitely a little steep on a LEGO Creator 3-in-1 set. But it looks absolutely massive. Comes with a tree and a peacock. So we also got the Space Astronaut, a set I really enjoyed building. Such a cool piece to my collection. But again, getting that space logo for $55. Hamster wheel. Maybe put a real hamster on here. I don't know. I'm just kidding. But pretty cool looking set. Again, being a 3-in-1, comes for $30. The retro roller skate we also reviewed on this channel is for $30. I think this was definitely a little bit of a fan favorite just on the pastel colors. Overall, looks really good. We have a red dragon, nice little $10 build, maybe a little gift set. Overall, pretty cool looking dragon. And then lastly, we have the flatbed truck with the helicopter. Again, this is a creator 3-in-1 set. You can build a couple different cars inside this set. So anyways, the flatbed looks pretty good in my opinion. More or less feels like a Lego City set, but we'll take it as a creator. I'm assuming it's probably not minifig scale and accessibility just because it is a creator, but we'd have to build it just to know. As far as other Lego Disney sets, we already talked about the Brickheadz that's coming out. We also have mini Disney Ariel's Castle. We also have Rapunzel's Tower on this Snuggly Duckling. I'm sure that will be a very popular one. Getting Rapunzel's Tower is a nice little Lego set for sure. Disney Princess Market Adventures for $100. Looks like we are getting some Lego Cars Duplo sets. It's Mac at the Race. Cool to see Mac in a Cars form again. We have Elsa's Frozen Treats. We have Belle's Storytime Horse Carriage. We have Elsa's Frozen Castle in the 4+ line. And lastly, we have Elsa and Bruni in the Enchanted Forest. Again, solid and strong line. I'm not going to go through the Lego Duplo sets, but they are a handful that are going to be releasing. So definitely check those out if you're into the Duplo. We already covered the Mac of the Race. Moving on to the next Lego theme, of course, is going to be Lego Friends. And I think Lego Friends has been an absolutely stellar theme over the last, I would say, couple of years. But I feel like 2024 is getting even stronger here. In particular, this set right here, Andrea's Modern Mansion. I'm going to open this one up big screen just because I think this set is incredible. So again, January 1st release. It's a Modern Mansion by all means. It looks absolutely amazing. I love this set. I am not a, you know, Friends enthusiast, right? Like, I don't collect the mini dolls or anything like that. But this is a set I probably see myself trying to get my hands on, especially before it retires or whatever. Because this set looks, I mean, it's impressive, guys. I love modern houses. For those of you who don't know, me and Georgiana's ultimate dream one day is build a modern mansion. And I think this is definitely a great image of what something one might look like, right? I love the garage on the first floor, too. Almost reminds me of, like, a California mansion, but really cool one. $200, a little high price point, 2,275 pieces, and a boatload of mini dolls. So anyways, that's the first one. We also have Heart Lake City Shopping Mall, another really strong Lego set in my eyes. Again, more in the outdoor, you know, very nice climate of California or something like that, outdoor mall or something like that. So really cool set. We have Ollie and Paisley's Family Houses. Again, another really decent, I would say very strong modern house for the Lego Friends line. Heart Lake City Hospital. Again, a great looking set. We have a hot dog food truck. Really cool. We have the Stargazing Camping Vehicle. We have the Hamster Playground, the Heart Lake City Hospital Ambulance, a Popstar Music's Tour Bus, a Mars Space Base and Rocket. This one, of course, getting the space logo on the front set for $80. We have a City Adventure Playground Adventure. We have the Farm Animals Sanctuary. We have the Heart Lake City Music Talent Show, the Vintage Fashion Store, the Tiny Accessory Store, Autumn Baby Cow Shed, Mobile Bakery Food Cart, and a couple more sets here on this last page. The Pet Adoptions Day, the Horse and Pony Trailer, the Electric Car and Charging Station, which I think is a decent little set for $16. I love the electric car packs. I think those are really cool. We have the Karaoke Music Party and a Farm Animal Vet Clinic. I know that was a mouthful. It was a lot of friends set, but truthfully, a really, really strong theme going into 2024. Now, unfortunately, a theme that I don't think is very strong is going to be the Harry Potter wave for 2024. We could briefly talk about those. First, we get the Flying Ford Anglia, if I'm pronouncing that correct, sorry. This one's for $15. Again, feels more of a $9.99 set. 165 pieces, $15 does seem a little steep, but overall, again, it's a pretty iconic car from the Harry Potter theme. We have Hagrid's Hut and Unexpected Visit. For those of you who don't know, this set was available, I think, in like 2018 or 2019. Honestly, at a bigger scale, looked better, better colors. I believe the same minifigs, maybe one less, and it retailed for $60. As the Hagrid's Hut. So this one's $75 coming here on January 1st. Extremely overpriced in my eyes. And overall, I don't think it looks as good as the predecessor one that we've seen in past years. But anyways, that's my opinion. We also have the Hogwarts Castle Hourly. Again, absurdly overpriced in my eyes. This feels more of like a $30 set. And it's at $45. A really cool one is the Forbidden Forest Magical Creatures. Again, I think it's overpriced. That is not even, I'm sorry guys, the Lego Harry Potter is definitely a March release, not a January. Sorry. Regardless, I wanted to cover all the coming soon sets. It's been a while since we did this, but we also have the Hedwig and the Four Pivot Drive for 20, and then the Hogwarts Castle Boathouse for 37. Again, being an overpriced. Regardless, these 2024 sets, I feel like a little bit overpriced in my eyes. I'm not sure if the Jurassic World sets are January 1st release. Yeah, they are. Okay. We have two Jurassic World sets moving on from Harry Potter. We have the Dinosaur Fossils T-Rex Skull. Solid set in my eyes, guys. I think this is a really cool and unique set. When I first saw this on like Instagram, whenever like the leaks or something came out, I thought I was like, wow, that looks awesome. So $40 for that one. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like you can get any minifigs in that, but really cool build. I love this. You can leave even the podium here. That's awesome. And then also we got one other set here, and this is the Baby Dinosaur Rescue Center. And I believe that one is, yeah, that was also January 1st release. It is a 4-plus set, so for $40, not completely high up on my list, but that covers it for Jurassic World. We did cover the LEGO Dreams releases on our channel. I'm going to say a very less exciting compared to the first wave of LEGO Dreams. Honestly, guys, we covered it in our video, but to reiterate, I think the only good, solid one, especially for the price point, would be Mr. Oz's Space Car. I'm just surprised they put it at a, I would say, reasonable retail price of $30 because it got the space logo. Thought they would mark it up. I was actually impressed with this set without including the there was three bags in this one. If you build the first two bags, you got like a moving car that was like fully functional as like a car, and then you can add it as a rover or a this like spaceship with a third bag. So truthfully, you'd only need two bags in the set and make it pretty cool looking Lego set. So I was really impressed with that one. The rest I just felt like were heavily overpriced. The Zoe and Zion the Cat Owl was a cool set, but for $50 is absurd. It feels more on the longs, maybe a $35 set. The Sandman Tower, I said it in the video, was just a very blank build. The minifigs were awesome, but the build itself was pretty meh. Especially for $90. Again, $50 was a solid price point in my eyes for the set. Mateo's Off-Road Car, again, it's a $10 pack. Of course, I'd be happy at $5, right? And then the Izzy's Narwhal Hot Air Balloon, it just felt more of a $10 set, not a $16. So those are all the dream sets. They could have been better in my eyes, but we do have a few other sets from the Lego Icons theme that are going to be dropping. The Dunes Royal Othrumpopter, I don't know how to pronounce it. That set is not coming out until March, I believe. But the Bouquet of Roses is for $60. I think this is a very strong Lego Icon set, especially for the floral line. Really beautiful set. I'm impressed with this one. $60 again seems a little bit steep, but the roses that will last forever, and you're gonna spend $40-$50 on roses anyways at the grocery store. So that's my thoughts there. I think it's a solid price point. Next, we do have a Sonic set that is going to be releasing. I'll double check this one. It is going to be for $35. It's Knuckles Guardian Mech. You guys know me. I love a good mech. And of course, relating to Sonic, seems a little bit overpriced. But when it goes on sale, I think I will get it because I do want a Sonic mech. That'd be pretty cool. Knuckles looks pretty bad as. He looks cool. Anyways, jumping on to LEGO Mario. There's a few sets that are going to be coming out from LEGO Mario. I believe the Bowser one is January 1st. Yes. So this is probably one of my favorite ones that is going to come out. Bowser's Muscle Car expansion set. I am not a Super Mario fan in the lines of like the little PlayScale LEGO Super Mario, but this set, I have to get it. It looks awesome. And you have Bowser riding his freaking muscle car, dropping bombs. Dude, this thing is like, it's a calling card to my, you know, youth. And for $30, I think like it's very reasonable, especially for like a Brickville Bowser minifig, the nice big car. I'm impressed. I think it's a really good set. We also have the $45 Dory Sunken Shipwreck. Again, not a set for me, but if you're a Mario enthusiast, I'm sure you're picking up some of these. One that I was planning on buying absolutely day one was this one right here. It was the Yoshi's Excellent Forest Expansion set. I was very fortunate LEGO decided to send me this one as part of the LEGO Ambassador Network. I got to review it on the channel. I mean, it was only a $10 set. I was going to buy it anyways, but for $10, I thought buying for $10, two Yoshis plus the egg, I thought it was a great value. I really like the Yoshis. I've been trying to collect them. I have like a green, yellow, orange. I think those are the only three I have now. The pink, obviously, now. But anyways, I was pretty excited to get the pink Yoshi for getting this pack. So anyways, $10, two Yoshis. Really stoked about that one. That covers it for Mario. Let's jump into LEGO Marvel. You guys know I'm not a big Marvel fan, but we do have a handful of LEGO Marvel releases that are going to be coming out on January 1st. The first one is the Spider-Man mask. I think it overall looks good. I think I've seen a lot of people complain about it, but overall, I think it's a great looking helmet collection series. I think it's gonna, I don't think we've seen, have we seen the Spider-Man? Yeah, I think we did. Anyways, regardless, it looks really good. We have the X-Men X Jet for $85. Again, a set that feels very overpriced. We have Rocket and Baby Groot. Brick Built, looks meh. $60, overpriced. I don't know. Bunch of keychains. We have Spider-Man vs. Sandman Final Battle, $38. We have the Motorcycle Chase Spider-Man vs. Dr. Ock, $10 for 2 minifigs. I think that's pretty reasonable. We have the Spider-Man Race Car and Venom Green Goblin for $35. Definitely upset that feels heavily overpriced, but I would say it looks pretty cool. We have a War Machine Mech Armor for $15. We have a Venom Mech Armor versus Miles Morales for $15. We have the Rocket Warbird vs. Ronin, $38. Team Spidey Web's Spinner Headquarters, $55. And Spidey vs. Green Goblin for $20. Again, I'm not a huge Marvel buff, so I'm not going to cover and sit on that theme. Let's go ahead and jump to LEGO Minecraft, where we are getting some really cool and interesting sets, I would say. I am not a big Minecraft fan, but some of these sets really get me, they really get me going. So the Turtle Beach House, I mean, who doesn't want a Turtle Beach House in their collection? This looks awesome. $27, again, seems a little steep. It more or less felt like a $20 LEGO set, but obviously inflation hitting the LEGO market pretty heavily. Hopefully we see some rollback prices on some of these, but it is kind of like a modular style where you can raise the roof and look inside of it, but overall, a really, really cool set. To go along with that, we have the Devourer Showdown. $45 for 420 pieces. Nice brick build character there. Look at the guy riding a very colorful bird. We also have the Frog House. I thought that one was pretty awesome and unique as well. For $55, we have a Steve's Desert Expedition. Get a llama in that one. I forget what this character is called, but it's been a while since I played Minecraft. The Nether Portal Ambush for $38. Just very high on the price point, I would say, for the entire Minecraft theme. But more or less, I think it is a strong LEGO theme and looks really good. We do have a new CMF series that's going to be releasing. We can open up these. They are going to be releasing it for $4.99. So nice to see the price point has not changed. $5 LEGO CMF packs. Series 25, of course, it is going to be, I think it was 12 or 16, I should say. 12 to collect. I would say a very strong CMF line. Unfortunately, it is in boxes, so we're not going to be able to tell which minifigs we are getting. Obviously, from the videos I've been posting on Shorts where people just open it up in stores, I don't see the boxes lasting very long. Regardless, I think it's a very strong CMF series. If I could find just an entire box, I would buy the entire box just to have it. I really want the goat. Obviously, this character right here, I'd love to army build. I know my uncle would like to army build. Obviously, that's going to be impossible with not having bags and being able to fill them instead of having boxes. But anyways, that's a really cool minifig. I'm really excited for that series, and I hope you guys are as well, because I think it's pretty strong. Next up, we have Monkie Kid. I think the best set out of this one is Megapolis City 5th Anniversary. Can't believe it's already a 5th anniversary for LEGO Monkie Kid, but again, a very strong line. Unfortunately, I don't see these sets go on sale pretty basically ever, but they have really epic LEGO sets. But this one reminds me of Ninjago City a bit. Really cool set. We have Mai's Dragon Mech. You guys know I love a good mech. This is pretty epic. $100. Incredible looking set. We have Creative Vehicles Pack here for $35. Seems a little bit high on the price point, but you get three little vehicles that get incorporated in there. And we also have Monkey Kid's Mini Mech. So again, another little mech build there on basically what seems to be a brick built cloud. So solid wave there. I'm really impressed with this Maze Dragon Mech. I definitely want to get that one. I'm not sure if I'll get Megapolis, but a really cool set. Next up, we have Ninjago, which fortunately, again, is a theme we covered on here, the channel, because LEGO had gifted us these sets early for review. Again, I think this was the most impressive January 1st release in my eyes, simply because the price point felt amazing and very, very reasonable in my eyes. So one thing to call out is the three mechs that are going to be releasing here. So we have Sora's Elemental Tech Mech, we have Cole's Elemental Earth Mech, and we have Kai's Elemental Fire Mech. All three of these are interchangeable, so you could like take off the hands from Kai's mech, put them on the base of Sora's, and then take the legs and put it on Sora's. Like, they're all interchangeable, like, same things for the weapons. I think it was a really cool feature. They retail for $20, these two right here, which I think is a great value for two minifigs and 235 pieces. And overall, a very larger size LEGO set. And then this one's $30, but you do get a second mech inside the build that is definitely smaller. Kai's mech is a little bit bigger than the other two as well, so do keep it in mind. So really solid there. We also have Igalt the Master Dragon for $70. I think this is a little bit high on the price point. I think it should have been a $60 set, but definitely high on the price point. Overall, though, it was an impressive dragon. It's probably one of my favorite dragons in my collection. I just love his beard. That's kind of why. Next up, we have Kai Sorcerer's Dragon. We did not review this one. We did not receive this one. It is a 4-plus line, but $37 seems steep. We have Jay's Mech Battle, $10 here. This has to be one of the best packs I've seen in a very long time. It's basically a battle pack, Jay's mech battle pack. You get two of the warriors, you get Lloyd, and you get Jay for $10. Four minifig for $10, I think, is a mess up on LEGO's part. That just seems absurd. It's not every day you can get a minifig, a brand new minifig in a LEGO set for $2.50, essentially. And here it is in this battle pack. I think it's an amazing pack. Next, we have the Dragon Strikes. We have Erin's, Ty's, and Nia's. Enough said there. There's two minifigs, a dragon that you could push this little thing down, and a dragon shoots out for $10. And lastly, we have Erin's Battle Mech. Two minifigs in this one. Should have been a $10 pack in my eyes, but it is $16. Definitely an overpriced one. All right. Next up, we have the others. So we have a lot of the Chinese New Year sets. I think the best one here is the Auspicious Dragon. A really cool LEGO set here, $90. We have Cherry Blossoms. We have the Family Reunion Celebration. Okay, I said my favorite was the dragon, but I think this one actually was. I wish it was almost modular, but it does have a dollhouse style on the back. But regardless, I mean, this thing's absolutely gorgeous. I'd probably love to get two of these and mock the back up and make it a complete building. But overall, looks incredible. We have a Japan postcard. We have the festive calendar. We have Hedgehog picnic date. I'm not even sure. Is this from what? Oh, this is the like other. This is actually the other category. I'm like, what theme is this? And we have a spring animal playground. Enough said there. Moving on forward, we have a couple more themes to hit. We have the Spider-Man, which we've already collected in the Marvel area, and then we also have the LEGO Star Wars. Only two LEGO Star Wars sets coming out in January 4th, unfortunately. We've already seen these on the channel early in stores. I haven't picked them up yet, but we have the Clone Trooper Battle Droid and Battle Droid Battle Pack. I think this is probably, I don't know how people are like arguing about this set. This has to be one of the best battle packs we've seen in a very long time. You get three super battle droids, two droids, and four clone troopers. I mean, man, I don't know what else to say. I don't. For $30, for me, this would have been easily a $40. I think LEGO really, really maybe struggled in sales this year, and they kicked back prices just a little bit. $30 for me, I'm buying at retail. Like, I am not. I think this is a sellout, a day one sellout. I think a lot of people are going to be picking this up for the minifigs, obviously. I'm impressed with it. Overall, great set. $50 for the Crimson Firehawk, overpriced. This should be a $30 set. Like, absolutely, maybe even 20. But anyways, three minifigs in there from the Young Jedi. So that's it for Star Wars. And then lastly, we have some LEGO TechKnit sets. We have Planet Earth and Moon in Orbit, meaning part of the space. We have the VDOL Heavy Cargo Spaceship, again, being a part of the LEGO Space. We have Mars Cruise Exploration Rover, again, being a part of the LEGO Space. I'm not sure if the Kawasaki is a January 1st release. I'll have to double check that. No, it's not. It's a March. Same thing with the McLaren. This one is the Surface Space Loader. That is a January 1st release. We have a Mack LR garbage truck. We have a nice John Deere tractor here, the Harvester. We have the McLaren Extreme Eracer. I'm not even sure if that one was. The heavy duty bulldozer and the off-road race buggy. So pretty basic on the LEGO Technic sets. A lot of the space ones coming out obviously are going to be probably a hit. Getting that space logo on there. This one actually seems really, really cool. In my eyes, probably the best tech. I'm not a Technic fan, guys, but for $75, this thing was awesome. You rotate it here and let it planet Earth rotates around the sun. I mean, it's an impressive set, something unique, something different. I love to see different things, especially from the LEGO group. But anyways, guys, that's a long, laundry list of LEGO sets. I'm sure I didn't even cover all of them, but I hope that satisfies you guys for now. We will be doing something special, of course, for January 1st, where we shop and add a LEGO plushie every first of the month, and we buy and shop, swipe the card irresponsibly. You know what we do, guys. But that's gonna wrap it up for every first of the month release. Thanks for staying in. I'll try to chapter this off so you guys can jump to the LEGO themes that you're interested in and some of my general thoughts that we covered in today's video. But let me know what you guys think in the comments below. What LEGO sets are you buying January 1st? Help me plan out my guide to buying on January 1st. I think obviously the Clone Trooper and Battle Droid pack is definitely going to be in that haul, in the first of the month haul, but we'll see what else we end up grabbing. Anyways, that's going to wrap it up. Love you guys. Make sure to hit that subscribe button. We'll see you in the next video, and make sure to see you at the January 1st release. Love you guys. Peace out.